good to be here again, and good to see y'all.
Amen.
And I tell you what, you young people, I look at my boys, and they're growing up, fixing to be gone out of the house. I got two still at home. And I always tell my boys, I said, talk to people.
Amen.
That's what we do.
Amen. That's right.
And you know what another Christian does for another Christian?
Encourage.
They encourage each other.
Amen. Right?
And it's good to have Christian fellowship.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I appreciate y'all letting us come, and it's a privilege to be able to.
Amen.
This is coming to me.
But it got me under conviction.
Amen.
And I went home and I was sitting in my bed and I was thinking about my dad's testimony and how he was sitting in his bed and then he rolled over on his hands and knees and got saved. And I was like,
amen.
If we drove off in the night and then I got in a car wreck and died, I would go to hell. And I didn't want to go to hell.
Amen.
So. And so I ran into Mom and Dad's bedroom, and I went, Mom, Dad, I'm going to hell. How do I get saved? And so I got saved on my Mom and Dad's bed.
Amen. 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 Amen.
best thing you can ever do is get saved.
Amen.
You get to know where you're going when you die.
Yep.
And living by faith. It's a blessing to be saved, and I don't know about y'all, but when I look at my family, the number one thing in my mind is I want every one of them to know that they're saved and they're going to heaven.
Amen. Amen. That's right.
And you never know what's going to happen to a person.
Right.
And that's the most important thing, and I've always told the boys, I said, you need to know where you're going when you die.
Right. Yeah.
You need to know that. And I put him on the spot. I didn't tell him I was going to let him give his testimony or anything. But that's, I remember when Isaac got saved, he come up there, he's just a little guy. And somebody says, oh, little guys can't get you. Yeah, they can.
Amen.
Yeah, they can.
Yeah.
He come up, he was worried about hell, and he says, I need to get saved. I need to get this over with.
Amen.
So we showed him how to pray, and said, you just trust Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You believe that he died for your sins and he rose again. And you get on your knees and trust him and ask him to save your soul.
Amen.
He goes, and he did that. And I said, amen. And he goes, is that all? I said, that's it. You know, salvation is easy for a young person to get saved.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
And I'm glad the Lord made it that way.
Yep.
He made it so easy, us smart people.
Yeah.
The wise and the rich, the important people, they look right over salvation and miss it.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you what, it's a bad thing to do. Don't miss being saved.
Amen.
Proverbs chapter 29. Proverbs is a blessing to work with young teenagers and take them fishing, take them hunting, watch them grow in the Lord, watch them get saved, watch them memorize the Bible, watch them do that right there, sing. Yeah. Quote the scriptures. You say, did they all do right? Well, most of them went right back to what they was doing.
Yeah.
But they had a chance.
Amen.
Amen. They had a chance.
And
that's what we do.
Yeah.
That's what we do as a pastor. As a church, you give them a chance to do right.
Yeah.
Amen. All right. Proverbs chapter 29. Proverbs chapter verse. And it says, where there is no vision, the people perish. But he that keepeth the law, I pray you will bless this message, Lord, for your honor, your glory, and Lord, help me to say what you want me to say, and Lord, help us to have a vision. And I pray that you'll bless this message now, in Jesus' name, amen. Where there is no vision, the people perish. Now, I'm 45 years old, And I forgot them today. I'm right at that brink where you got to have... Your reading gets blurred.
Yes, sir.
And I'm right there where I'm not used to putting glasses in my pocket or anything. And my vision is not like it used to be. I get excited, and you'll see me picking that thing up, doing that right there.
Yeah.
Picking the Bible up. Now, you got to watch. It says, where there is no vision, the people perish. Yeah. But he that keepeth the law, happy is he.
Amen.
Now, you need to have a vision.
Amen.
You need to have a vision. Let me ask you, young people, you got a vision of your family in the future? You may not even be married.
Yeah.
You got a vision of going to church?
Amen.
You got a vision of getting family altar and getting around your table and praying before you eat?
Amen.
You got a vision of working hard and holding down a job and feeding your family.
Amen.
Amen. You know, when you start out in life as a married couple, as a young married couple, you got a vision to have a family.
Right.
Amen. You know what? There's visions. When somebody gives me a job to do, you know what first thing I do? I go out there and I look at it.
Yeah.
And the pipe's not there. Conduit run's not there. The wire's not there. And I just look at the rack, look at my route, look at the obstacles, and then all of a sudden I see a pipe up there.
Amen.
And I'll run my eyes down it, and I'll say, that goes there, and that goes there. And you got to have a vision to do that, to do a job. If you build a house, you look at your house, and it's not laying there. It's got to have a foundation. It's got to have everything dug out. You look at a real... Well, you get some paper, you start planning, you say, I want it to have this bedroom, I want this bedroom here, and I want the bathroom right here, and I got to have a mud room here, and they got to have a place to hang the coats, because I don't want coats laying around, and you got to have good cupboard space for my wife.
Amen.
Amen. And you got to have a vision to be able to build a house.
Yeah. Right.
Bible says, where there is no vision, the people perish.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know, a church ought to have a vision of winning souls and things like that. And I want to go over some things about vision. Here's something right here in Mount Rushmore. Anybody ever been to Mount Rushmore? I haven't been over there either. Put my hand down. But I've been around there. But Mount Rushmore, it was built in 1927. That's the Depression. Coming out of the Depression, 1941. It took 14 years to carve them four faces. Theodore Roosevelt, Abraham Lincoln, George Washington, and Thomas Jefferson. Them four presidents. And it took 400 men and women to carve that out for 14 years. They got $8 a day for pay. $8 a day for pay. They took dynamite and blasted it. There was no casualty for that. They took cables and let them people down on the face and planted dynamite and took up and blew it. And then when they got close, they took drill and drilled holes in there, made a honeycomb and just fouled it down. They was up there working, and there was a story I read about it, where they'd break off that honeycomb where they drilled holes in it, and the tourists would come by and think it was real rock. They'd say, I'll give you $2 for that. They'd act like, well, man, my boss really needs this. And he'd wait till they'd bring the price up and say, okay, I'll give $6 for it, and they'd take it. You know, make the money on it. And all it was a group saying, you know, they just drilling holes through it. But anyway, you know, the man that started to have a vision. You know how old he was when he had that vision to build Mount Rushmore? He was 69 years old. 69 years old. Took him 14 years to build it, and he saw it through.
Amen.
He saw it through. You know what he had? He had a vision to do that. You know, anything you do for Jesus Christ, you ought to do it for the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And the Bible says, I mean, what you do for Jesus Christ, you ought to have a vision for the Lord Jesus Christ. And I want to preach about some visions that you ought to have. Mount Rushmore was a vision, and all it is a tourist thing, but a lot of people go and look at that. It attracts a lot of people. Amen. What is your vision for the Lord Jesus Christ? Yeah. What is your vision? All right, number one, what makes a good vision? The Bible says where there is no vision, the people perish.
Right. Yeah.
You ought to have a vision for the Bible.
Amen. Amen. Right.
You ought to have a vision for this book.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of people, they don't even know which book to go by.
Amen.
They got the NIV, RSV, ASV, New King James Bible. You got there's 100 different versions.
Yeah.
Which one's the right one?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you right now, you got the old King James 1611. Amen. And you say, preacher, you go by that? Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
I go by it.
Amen.
I bet my soul on this book.
Yeah.
This book governs my life.
Amen.
And matter of fact, I put everything I have on this book. You know why? Because it's perfect.
Amen.
The Bible says the words of the Lord are pure words, as silver tried in the furnace of earth, purified seven times.
Yeah.
Thou shalt keep them, O Lord. Thou shalt preserve them from this generation forever.
Amen.
There's a lot of people, they'll come around and they'll start saying this, and I say, you know, the NIV, it don't even have Acts 16:31 there. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved.
Yeah.
They took it out.
Yeah.
And a lot of things happened. You know, they even got a Bible now where, I mean, it's just blasphemy.
Yeah.
It's a Bible that's for any type of people that you could imagine.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? It's in the King James Bible.
Amen.
I remember my dad, he'd say, now this is the Word of God.
Yeah.
And he'd tell us why. And I've always, you know, I've got that. And then I got saved and I trusted Jesus Christ. And then I started studying this book. And then I started finding out why it's the Word
Amen.
Of God.
Yeah.
And there is no better book. Now let me tell you this. There's been more people killed over that book.
Amen. Yeah.
There is no book more hated than that book.
Right.
There is no book more loved than that
Amen.
Book. There is no book sold. There is no other that's outsold every book in the
yep.
world. That's the most popular book in the world. And it's the most hated. It's the most despised. It's the most, they tried to destroy it. And yet it's the book of books.
Right.
Amen.
Oh, yes.
Amen. That book is supernatural.
Amen.
You say, that's a super, yeah, it's a super book.
Amen. Right.
And you know, people look right over that Bible and they don't read it and they don't spend time. But you know what you need to do? You need to get a vision from this book.
Right.
You need to read that book. You're not going to get a vision if you don't read it.
Right.
You got to read it. Boys are trying to read the Bible, going through. And I've always told my boys, I said, you at least read it one time.
Yeah.
You read it once, you got to read twice.
Amen.
Read it twice, you got to read it again.
Amen.
Read it. Read it. And why? This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate in them day and night.
Yeah.
You keep your mind on the Word of God. I got a little card in here. Here's another thing what you need to do is memorize it.
Amen.
Start carrying scripture cards in your pocket.
Yeah. Right.
This one is... I haven't memorized it yet. He that committeth sin is of the devil.
Yeah.
For the devil sinneth from the beginning. For this purpose the Son of God was manifested, that he might destroy the works of the devil.
Yeah.
Boy, that's a good verse.
Amen.
And it hit me hard. I said, man, that's a good one. I'm going to write that one down. Flipped it over and put on the back, and I got this one half memorized. Ye are of your father the devil, John 8:44.
Yeah.
The lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it.
Yeah.
But let me tell you something. You take that right there, you read it and say, that's a good verse. But you know, you got to do more than that.
Yeah.
Put it in here.
Amen.
You got to do more than that. Then you got to start going to bed thinking about it.
Yeah.
Amen?
Amen.
When you say, Lord, I got that verse, I'm memorizing, what do you think about that verse, God?
Yeah.
What do I need to get out of that verse? Show me something from that verse. Yeah. And you're sitting there laying down. And he that committed sin is of the devil. That means you better not be sinning.
Yeah. Right.
What do you do? What do I do with my sin, God? You better confess it to God.
Amen.
Don't you confess it to people. Confess it to the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. If you sin personally to somebody, you go up to that person and say, man, I'm sorry. I messed up.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. What can I do to make it right? Amen.
Amen.
That's from the Bible.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You meditate on it. You know what that'll do? That'll give you a vision.
Yeah.
That'll give you a vision to live for the Lord Jesus Christ. Psalms 119:40, it says, thy word is very pure, therefore thy servant loveth it. Vision of the word to keep your kids clean. Thy word have I hid in my heart that I might not sin against thee. Amen.
Amen.
Right. Wherewithal shall a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed thereto, according to thy word.
Right.
You know how to help your kids? Get the Bible in them.
Amen.
Right. Put the Bible in there. Read the Bible to them. That's, they got all these little programs and everything like that. My dad, his program was you be home at night.
Amen.
And we get around and we'll round one verse at a time. Everybody go around in circles. We'll start at Genesis and we'll read through that book.
Yeah.
It took us a while, but we got through the Bible and we read. And if we started cutting up, Dad would say, hey, it's God's word. Sit up. Let's read the Bible. Y'all know where I'm at? My dad was a disciplinarian.
Amen.
Alrighty, vision of the word. You know, knowing that book will keep you from sin.
Right.
I do things, and I can do things, and I can see my dad looking at me.
Yeah.
And then a verse pops up in my head.
Yeah.
It's that Bible.
Amen.
That Bible. It helps us. You know what that Bible is? It's a good flashlight.
Right. Right.
The word of God is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Psalms 119:105. That Bible's comfort.
Amen.
That Bible will comfort your soul.
Yeah.
That Bible will help you. How much do you love the word of God? Do you meditate on it? You think about it?
Right.
You keep your mind on it and meditate. The Bible will talk to you.
Yeah.
You say, what are you talking about? Well, let me show you. Look at Proverbs chapter 6. Proverbs chapter 6. It says, my son, verse 20, my son, keep thy father's commandment and forsake not the law of thy mother. Bind them continually on thine heart and tie them about thy neck. And when thou goest, it shall lead thee. When thou sleepest, it shall keep thee. And when thou awakest, it shall talk with thee.
Amen.
Y'all ever wake up? I'm sure you have. You wake up and there's a Bible verse right on your mind. I like to wake up and there's a church song going right in my mind. None of that bad, filthy stuff.
Amen. Yep.
Right.
I don't want to listen to it because I don't want to wake up to it. Y'all ever want to get in a bad mood? Turn one of them radio. Y'all remember them radio alarm clocks? That'll put you in a bad mood when it's on a bad channel. Hit that thing and tear it up. There, it's done. Amen. I like waking up to hearing good stuff.
Amen.
Amen. All right, here's number two. You need a clear vision of heaven.
Yeah, that's right, preacher.
Abraham journeyed and going through the land to the land of promise. And you know what it says in Hebrews? It says he looked for a city.
Amen.
Whose maker and ruler is God.
Yeah.
Looking for a city.
That's right.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Looking for
Amen.
For heaven.
Amen.
You know, we need to keep heaven on our mind.
Yeah.
Say, what's heaven like? Well, I'm just going to go through the alphabet real quick. In heaven, I'm going to tell you what's not in heaven.
Yeah.
A, no adulterers.
Amen.
No anger. No antichrist. You ever see anybody shake your fist at God.
Yeah.
Go street preaching. You'll see it.
Yeah.
We'll get out there. We'll raise our Bible and say, the Bible says, believe on the Lord Jesus. And they'll say, keep that in church.
Yeah.
And then sometimes they give you the one finger salute. All righty. Say, where'd you learn that from? My dad did that with me. Amen. Adulterers, no anger. Antichrist, no antichrist up there. Aching bones, no aching bones in heaven. Amen. No arthritis, no accidents. Bad stuff. B, no bail. No beer.
Yeah. Amen.
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 Amen. No beer. No bath salt. Y'all know what that is? That's the dopeies. They know what it is. No bills.
Amen.
Amen. No bills. No curse. For C. No covetousness. No cancer.
Amen.
No colds. No communist.
Amen. Amen.
No crack cocaine.
Yeah.
That stuff kills people.
Yeah. That's right, bro.
You know what's the number one killer, though? It's liquor.
Yeah, that's right.
People get killed with that.
Yeah.
I remember somebody says, you ever taste beer? No, I ain't never tasted it. I don't plan on starting.
Amen.
And what if I did? I might be a drunk the rest of my life.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be up here.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
You say, oh, you're strong. You never know.
Yeah.
You never know. Don't try it.
Hey.
Don't try it, and don't give an occasion for your flesh to do wrong.
Right.
Amen. Right. Young people, I'd rather see my kids clean and never taste that stuff than
you're
taste
right.
it one time and end up a drunk.
Yep. Right,
bro. Amen.
Right.
All right. C, cancer. No cancer. No casualties, communists, crack, domain. D, no death.
Amen.
No death in heaven.
Yeah.
No diets.
Amen.
No devil, no Amen. Diseases. No drugs, no divorce.
Yeah.
No drunkenness. E, no evil, no envy, no enemies. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord will make everything right.
Yeah.
F, no false words, no false religion, no filthy gestures, no F word.
Amen.
I hate that word.
Yeah.
I hate it. And I think it's some favorite word in the construction field.
Yeah.
It's not going to be in heaven.
No.
It's not going to be there. No freezing. I have to build a fire every night. My boys have to build a fire. Because mama gets cold at night.
Yeah.
Keep the fire going.
Yeah.
All right, no gout for G. No gallstones, no glasses, no griping.
Amen.
H, no hypocrites in heaven.
That's right.
Now, let me ask you something. Y'all a hypocrite?
Right, bro.
Somebody told me the other day, they said, there's so many hypocrites in church. They told me, they said it just like that. And I looked at them, I said, yeah, I'm one. And I need the Lord.
Yeah.
Come on to church.
Yeah.
You might feel at home over there. Come on. Hey, you go to the bar. I don't hang around there or anything. But you know what I found out? I listen to people. You know what the first thing they do? They start looking at another woman.
Yeah.
And start talking about her. And talk behind their wife.
Yeah.
That's hypocrite.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Shouldn't talk like that.
Yeah.
Amen. You ought to be right. You ought to be right. No hypocrites in heaven. Thank God for the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. I, no idolaters. Mary worship. Wood statutes, idle words. Every idle word that men shall speak, he shall give an account thereof in the day of judgment. No phones in heaven.
Amen.
That's an idol.
Yeah.
That's what you spend most of your time with.
Right.
That's an idol.
Right.
Sports. That's an idol.
Yeah. Right.
You ought to spend more time in the Bible and prayer and things like that. J. No jails. No jealousy. K. No kidnapping.
Yeah.
My niece got kidnapped over in Malawi.
Yeah.
Thank the Lord God saved her.
Amen.
Got her out of that. Kidnapping, human trafficking, none of that. No killing. No kidney stones.
No.
No lying, no lust, no laziness, no lasciviousness, no liquor, no liberals.
Amen.
No lost people.
Amen.
You saved? Are you saved?
Right.
No nakedness. No bomb. No nuclear bombs.
Yeah.
No night. Revelation 21:5. No overeating.
Amen.
No ovarian cancer. My sister-in-law just come down with ovarian cancer. We pray for her. And I tell you what, my brother, he preaches in Montana and lost his first wife. She died and been married to this girl for 2 years, and she's down with ovarian cancer. No ovarian cancer. And I'll tell you what, God will heal you. God will heal you. P, no pride, no police. You a policeman in here? You won't need a job in heaven.
Amen.
No pornography.
Amen.
No perverts.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. It's a clean place.
Amen.
You don't have to listen to dirty jokes or anything. It's clean.
Right.
Amen. It's no politics.
Yeah. Yeah.
No queers.
Amen.
Right. Amen.
Right. Amen.
No sodomites up there.
Amen.
That's on the S. Hit it twice. No rapists.
Right.
No rap music.
Yeah.
Say, preacher, you hate me. I like my music like I like my candy with no rappers. Amen. No rotten fruit. No starving. No Satan.
Yeah.
No suicide. Young girl over in East Carter High School or middle school in the eighth grade hung herself. I asked my boy, he's in the eighth grade, I said, was she? Yeah, she was happy at school. She just sad to go home. That's sad.
Yeah.
Boy, I can't wait to get to heaven.
Amen, brother.
Why? I don't like to see that.
Yeah.
That's terrible.
Right.
That's a tragedy.
Yeah.
Put your kid there.
Yeah.
Don't ever want to see that. You see it more and more and more, and this world's getting worse and worse,
right,
and more people's doing that. Let me tell you something, if you're in here, listen, you got Christ to live for.
Amen.
Amen.
Christ died for your sins. By His stripes we are healed. You don't have to harm yourself. Jesus Christ died for you.
Amen, brother.
Amen. He took your place.
Amen.
Amen. You can have joy and happiness in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Right, right.
I mean, we live. For me to live is Christ.
Yeah.
Amen. No suicide in heaven.
Right.
No time limits.
Amen.
No television.
Amen.
I always say hellavision. Say, you got a TV? Yeah, I got one. But man, I got to shut that thing off.
Yeah.
unfaithfulness. None of that. None unrighteousness. Ugliness, ungodliness, unthankful, Romans 1:21.
Right.
That's Amen. Right. Neither were they
Amen.
Thankful. That's the first mark of being of a nation going down is
right.
Unthankfulness.
Amen.
Fullness, idleness, fullness of bread. V, no venereal diseases, vile affections, no vaping.
Amen.
No war, no whispers. That's what starts wars.
Right, brother.
No X-rated movies.
Yeah.
No yielding to sin.
Yeah.
Amen. And Z? I couldn't find one for Z. No zigzagging. No. Shoot straight. Amen. All right. Heaven's going to be a great place.
Yeah.
I always consider heaven as pure energy. You look at them little kids running around, just run, 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 and you're going, pure energy with no sin.
Amen.
That's heaven.
Right, right.
That's heaven. And it's going to be a great place. I have not seen nor ear heard the things that God's prepared for us in heaven.
Right.
You can't even imagine it.
Right.
It's better than what you think.
Yeah.
It's a great place.
Right.
All right. Number three, you ought to get a vision for lost souls.
Yeah. Right. Right. Mm-hmm.
Lost people. What is a lost soul? A lost soul is somebody who has never trusted Jesus Christ to save their soul
right.
from hell.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's a person that's lost. I'll ask a person, I say, are you saved? And they'll say, my daddy was saved.
Yeah.
That's the wrong answer.
Yeah.
You can't go to heaven on your dad's coattail.
Right.
Amen. You saved? I'm Baptist. That's the wrong answer.
Right. Yeah.
You
right.
can't go to heaven over your church.
Amen. Right.
Church will show you, but you can't go to heaven depending on your church.
Right.
You say, you saved? Well, I've been baptized. Baptism don't save you.
Right, right. Amen.
You can get dunked in that water. It's until you realize that Christ died for your sins, that he shed his blood for you,
right.
and that he rose again for you,
right.
and he paid your sin debt on the cross of Calvary. And then when you realize you're a sinner and you ask Jesus Christ to save you from your sin
yeah.
and save your soul, that's what saves you.
Amen.
That's what saves you. Alrighty, you ought to have a vision of lost souls.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this. Have you told everybody you know about Jesus Christ? Catch them at work.
Yeah.
I always try to catch them alone. It's a joke going on. I took one guy up in a lift. And we got way up there about 60 feet in the air and the wind blowing, and I cut the kill button. I said, Kenny, you saved?
Amen.
I said, you know why I'm telling you this? Because I don't want you to go to hell.
Amen.
Yeah.
I told him how to be saved. He didn't say no prayer or anything, but he listened to me.
Amen.
Sort of captive audience. Now he's saying, preacher, yeah, he hung me over the edge by my ankles. I said, yeah, I'll go get saved. Hey, it's fun being a Christian.
Amen.
It's fun being a Christian.
Yeah.
Tell them about the Lord. Make sure nobody escapes that Amen. Message.
Amen.
I knew one preacher, he said he used to stop at 5 houses every day.
Yeah.
Have some tracks and just at least give a track. Knock on the door and say, hey, can I give you this?
Yeah.
And look for an opportunity to say, hey, are you saved?
Amen.
Just five doors a day. That's a lot.
Well, yeah.
Nowadays, we don't hardly have COVID and everything going on. Nobody even knocks at the door anymore.
Yeah.
But I'm going to tell you something. That's how souls get saved.
Amen.
You need to have a vision. Running the buses.
Yeah.
Telling the kids. Bringing these kids to church. Preaching.
Yeah.
Preaching at them. All right, number four, you know what you need? You need a vision of holiness.
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
Boy, that right there, our God is a holy God.
Amen.
And there's two things that deserve the word holy in front of it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, God, a holy God,
yeah.
amen,
yeah.
and a holy Bible.
Amen.
I get a little uptight because smoke ain't holy.
Right. Amen.
Amen. It's not. And I've heard some filthy things with holy in front of it.
Yeah.
The Mormons has got it wrong. Underwear right. is not holy.
Yeah. Right, brother.
This is holy.
Amen.
Y'all know what I'm talking about? Y'all crazy. Where do
yeah.
people get that idea?
Amen.
They're worshiping things and not God.
Right.
And Jesus Christ, our God, is holy.
Amen.
The Lord Jesus Christ. There's no sin in him at all. You know, Pilate said, he said, I find no fault in him.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
You know what John the Baptist, he said, behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world.
Right.
Amen. That's the Lord Jesus Christ. He's holy.
Yeah.
And you know what? If you're saved in here, you're His child.
Amen.
And you know what that tells me? That tells me I got to live right.
Yeah.
I got to live right. Why? Because I don't want to shame my Father's name.
Yeah.
2 Timothy 2:19, it says, "Nevertheless, the foundation of God standeth sure, having this seal, the Lord knoweth them that are His, and let everyone that nameth the name of Christ," I'm a Christian,
yeah,
"nameth the name of Christ, depart from iniquity."
Right.
Amen. "But in a great house there are not only vessels of gold, silver, but also wood, earth, and some to honor and some to dishonor. If a man therefore purge himself from these, he shall be a vessel unto honor, sanctified, and meet for the master's use, and prepared unto every good work." Amen. Be a clean vessel for the Lord. Now, if I took a cup of water, and I say, "You thirsty?" Yeah. Now, anybody want to drink that? That's nasty. You know what we do? We live filthy and say, "Here I am, God."
Yeah.
God don't like to use a dirty vessel.
Right.
He can use you.
Right.
He can use you,
yeah,
no matter what. But I'm going to tell you what, He likes to use a clean vessel.
Amen.
Just like you like to drink out of a clean glass.
Right.
Amen.
Right.
Amen. Number five, the last point is you ought to have a vision of hell.
Yeah. Right.
Where there is no vision, the people perish.
Yeah.
You know why I like to tell people about Jesus Christ? I don't want to go to hell.
Amen.
You know why I got saved? Because I did not want to go to hell.
Yeah.
Amen.
That's
somebody
right,
says, "Did you?" I didn't think about the love of God.
Yeah.
I knew He loved me. I knew all. I thought about hell.
Yeah.
And I said, I don't want to be there forever,
right,
and burn for my sins when Christ died for me.
Right.
And I don't have to.
Amen.
Boy, I figured that out real quick. And when the Holy Spirit put His finger on me and I was on top of my bed and I said, "Oh man, I'm going to hell."
Yeah.
And you know what I did? I flipped over on my knees and I asked Jesus Christ to save my soul. And you know what I'll do? I'll tell somebody, we're working, and I say, "You know the best thing I ever did?" And they said, "What's that?" I said, "I trusted Jesus Christ as my personal Savior." Nothing comes close to that.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. You ought to get a vision of hell.
Yeah.
A vision of hell. Bible says the wicked shall be turned into hell, and all nations that forget God.
Yeah.
This nation right here,
yeah,
we don't say the Pledge of Allegiance anymore.
Right.
We don't have the Ten Commandments in school.
Right.
We don't have the Bible in school anymore.
Yeah.
My kids go to school. Boy, you gotta watch what they get taught.
Yeah.
You gotta talk to your kids. You know what I've been telling my kids? I said, your school is a mission field.
Yeah.
You tell them kids about Jesus,
amen,
Christ. Let them know how you got saved. Look them in the eye.
Yeah.
And you tell them that there's a holy Bible.
Yeah.
And you tell them about that. And you tell them about hell. You know why? They're going to hell if they don't trust Jesus Christ. They need to trust Jesus Christ. Look at Revelation chapter 20. Revelation chapter 20. Revelation 20, verse 15. It says, "And I saw the dead," verse 12, "small and great stand before God, and the books were opened. Another book was opened, which is the book of life, and the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books according to their works. And the sea gave up the dead which are in them, and death and hell delivered up the dead which were in them, and they were judged every man according to their works. And death and hell were cast in the lake of fire." This is the second death. You know what your soul is when you come into this world? You're dead in trespasses and sins.
Right. Mm-hmm. Right.
You know what messes? Your soul is trapped by sin.
Mm-hmm.
And it's stuck to an old wicked body.
Mm-hmm.
And the blood of Jesus Christ, the Bible says God will come along and He paid for your sins. The Bible says God is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. And the Lord Jesus Christ comes and He says, "You want to be saved from sin?
Yeah.
You want your soul saved? And some people will look at them and say, I think I've got to live it. And you say, well, why don't the Lord will knock on your door and he'll say, why don't you trust me to save you?
Yeah.
You say, well, I think I've got to straighten up first.
Yeah.
It'd take you you never can straighten up.
Amen.
Your flesh will mess up every time. And finally, if you give in, you say, okay, God, I want to be saved, and you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you believe what he did on the cross of Calvary, and you let Jesus Christ take your place, because God ain't going to make you get saved. It's up to you.
Amen.
It's your choice. Mm-hmm. And then you know what you do when you trust Jesus Christ? God will take his spiritual knife. And I always call it the Word of God. Being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. And he'll go,
yeah.
Say, what'd he do? He cuts your soul loose from sin.
Amen.
Right.
Amen. And my soul is set aside, and my filthy rags was put on Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
And then he took his clean robe and put it on me.
Yeah.
He took my place. Amen. Amen. He is my sacrifice.
Amen.
He's not going to make you take him.
No.
But he offers salvation freely.
Right. Right.
Amen. Have you ever trusted Jesus Christ? You know what I always say on the street corner? I always say there when they're going by, I say a good prayer. Is God be merciful to me, a sinner, and save my soul from hell.
Right.
Amen. That's the best thing I ever done. Amen. You know what you need? You need a vision of hell.
Yeah.
You need to think about it.
Yeah.
It's hot. It's forever. And I don't want nobody to go there.
No.
Nobody.
Amen.
Keep a vision of hell. Where there is no vision, the people perish. Number one, you ought to have a vision of the Bible. Number two, a clear vision of heaven. Number three, lost souls. Number four, holiness. Number five, a vision of hell. Father, I pray that you'll bless the message. Lord, bless everybody here. And God, help us to have a vision. And Lord, keep us renewed by your Spirit and the Word of God. Father, I pray that you'll bless the Word of God now and be with everybody here. Thank you, Lord, that they come. In Jesus' name.